Hi guys, I'm sorry of being late, for being late. This my Patreon concert sort of thing. I forgot the right word for it. Unfortunately, it's not gonna be 1 hour, and I hope I can record something nice for you and interesting tonight, and maybe I will record some more things. It works. Awesome. For now, I start with Great Gig in the Sky sort of tutorial. It's a very complicated arrangement to play. I find especially the feel. It's written here in my own score that you need to play it mostly with a swing feel, but I get a little bit confused. Unless you hear the original, it's a little bit confusing to understand what it's supposed to be. It's a very free piece, so right now I had to listen to it myself again, not to the original, to my arrangement. And I noticed that there are some things in my score that is not exactly the same. It's just... But the good thing is, it's a very free piece of music, so it's not a big deal. You play it how you feel. But I will just try to play from my score. And I hope I get it right. And I hope it's gonna be useful for you, because I find it difficult to teach music and explain things. I'm just not born to be a teacher or... Hello. I think you can see a cat ass. I think he saw a possibility. Smokey. Hello. We are busy here. Smokeball. Hello. Well, anyway, I will try to play with my cat or without him. Smokey! Grrr, stop purring.
Thank you.
hears a lot of complicated things, but I think good news is that you can always try to make it a bit simpler, like all these big jumps, octaves. Especially when like here, you can, instead of this, these kind of small things are always possible. I use it this, myself, and sometimes when I play a concert and I feel nervous, insecure, or like not in my best condition, or have headache, or maybe dizzy, this kind of shit helps, really. Highly recommend it. As long as the melody is very present and it sounds nice, who cares? Okay, Smokey. Ah, terrorist. Little terrorist. Okay, I will check what's gonna be next.
Classically trained pianist Vika has become known not for her classical interpretations, but for this kind of sound. If you didn't recognise the song, she was playing Raining Blood by the heavy metal band Slayer. And at that gig we just saw, she played the piano so hard that she actually broke a string on the piano. That is how passionate Vika is about this music, and she now has the opportunity to share her interpretations with the world.
Metallica instead of Mozart. Classically trained pianist Victoria Yermolyeva, better known as Vika, is currently touring Germany, playing covers of heavy metal and rock songs. In Berlin, she's performing at the club SO36, a favorite haunt of punk and hard rock fans.
What an experience seeing her on the stage. It's wild.
The way she gets into the songs, body and soul. It was ultra cool.
Really impressive. She's just incredible.
On her tour, Vika plays songs like Raining Blood by American thrash metal icon Slayer. Arranged for piano and drums, it might even win over non-metalheads.
I sometimes had reactions from people saying that they don't like all the noise of original songs, but when it's on piano, they actually can hear that the compositions are good. So it seems that some people discovered metal and rock because on piano arrangement it's just clear what music is about.
Vika began taking piano lessons when she was just 4, at first in her hometown of Kiev, Ukraine, and later elsewhere in Europe. She won countless prizes and played with various orchestras, but danced the nights away in heavy metal clubs.
I was sort of dragged into like going to competitions, or like I was always told to do that. I was never the one to pick up. Even when I was in my 20s, it was still decided for me, so I figure that it's not exactly my thing.
But all that changed in 2006, when Vika decided to follow her true passion and gave up her classical music career. Since then, her piano arrangements of classic metal and rock tunes have earned her a rapidly growing fan base on the internet. Vika never runs out of ideas for songs and simply plays what she likes. Her YouTube channel has racked up more than 77 million views.
One of my first covers was this upcoming new single from Metallica, from Death Magnetic, and when I uploaded it on YouTube, I skipped totally the hard part. I only played the soft part and then the ending. And then I suddenly started receiving all these messages and like comments, and I was like, oh wow, people like it.
Today, Vika can live from her passion, from performances, sales of sheet music, and donations from her fans. But most importantly, she's the master of her own destiny.
When it comes to concerts, it is of course a relief because I prefer this kind of stage. When I was a classical pianist, I was sometimes daydreaming about how to make it less, you know, like fancy, because it's like just really not me.
Now Vika is being true to herself, and she's working on the next stage of her career, creating arrangements for her first official CD.
So, next question was... Again, I cannot look at myself when I do that. Next question was to show a little bit how I do what I do. There are many things that I do, and probably 90% of that I shouldn't show. I guess it's meant about my arrangements. Haha, I'm so funny. Well, anyway, I thought maybe it's more interesting, or maybe it's not interesting at all, but there is no feedback right now, so I can just guess. I could show it with Liquido Narcotics. It's a cover I made myself. It was not any request, it was just a funny song that I thought I could cover. And as usually, I never know how it's gonna go. And it seemed like a very easy song to cover. So I wrote it down quite quickly because there is not much to write down. Everybody knows. But with simple songs, the problem is that sometimes on the piano, without all the special sounds and the voice and the lyrics and all the exciting shit, it sounds a bit like, so what? So what was it? Nothing to listen to. That's one problem that I have to figure out somehow. And then another problem was the voices that come all together and all very important, and I only have two hands. Obviously it's here. I'm sorry about mistakes. In the chorus, this going on, but also he sort of sing something, which was actually quite hard to figure out. So I listened also to a live version. That's another tip. Sometimes it's hard to figure something out from the original song, and then it helps to just listen to live version. I mean, this kind of thing is just like, it's right out there. I mean, it's probably very logical and easy to think about, but you know, just in case. For example, many songs, they end with a fade out, which is, it's very easy for rock music to make a song and make it fade out so you don't have to worry about the end. But what are you gonna do when you play it live? And then I listen to a live version and I was quite disappointed because the ending was really lame. I will show you. But first, chorus. So usually I play melody and all this accompaniment in the right hand, but sometimes it doesn't really work so well. It's just stupid, like... hard to hear and just creating a mess. It felt like not two separated voices, but just like a harmony. Didn't make any sense. So I put it into left hand. Better this way, but you never know, maybe there are more options. And about the ending. So it ends with this chorus that keeps on going and going and going and it fades out. But when they play live, instead of fading out, they play like this. Something like, fuck, okay, scratch it, I will try it again. I mean, not even with a little bit, you know, like, excitement. No, it's just like a fucking school exercise. I was highly disappointed. Maybe it was just that particular concert, I don't know. So I changed the ending. That's another problem which I sometimes have to deal with. When songs fade out or I don't like some parts, yeah, then I have to make something up. I hope that was in any way interesting. I mean, you asked for it, and I'm not really into like talking so much, so it's probably hard to listen to me. I hope you enjoy it. So I checked the comments and I swear, in my mailbox I received a comment of someone saying that I should record me dancing ridiculously like I used to. But for some reason this person deleted this comment, or I don't know, it didn't appear on my Patreon, but I can show you the screenshot if you want. I asked myself what was ridiculous about my dancing. There is no answer to that because I always took it very seriously. But since someone asked, and maybe I'm sure all of you are dying to see a 41, almost 42 year old woman dance, I will record a little bit of me dancing to Marilyn Manson Tainted Love. That was a song I danced to first on YouTube 13 years ago, actually 13 and a half. Freddy, you're here to see me doing shameful things. Good boy, my Freddy, he's a good boy. Check this out. Don't look. Okay, here we go. Thank you. hope you enjoy.
Don't rush, slow touch, run on wet. Like I go crunch, grab on back. They can go bust, eye for eye. They can lose trust. Why not? Fizzy pop, where you they go, go, you they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Damn the trash, man, it's so tough.
Alright, yo, put the belly on the body, make a clutch. See more.